I think Blevins at its core is three individuals striving to be the best selves that they can be, and doing that by articulating through the highest and lowest points of life to connect to other individuals.
It's also our last name.
Yeah, also those, our last name.
Who, those who don't know, yeah. We're brothers, by the way.
Yeah, three brothers. Miami. Can y'all feel that? Can y'all feel that? Jig it out. We are from Brackettville, Texas. Grew up in San Antonio and Laredo, but...
We grew up in Brackettville. We were born in San Antonio.
Super small town in Brackettville. Like 2,000 like people, the entire population. Super small town.
There's honestly not much to do, so we resorted to music, really.
Mm-hmm.
And we had a lot of time to do it.
So every day after school, Walt and Webb, our two friends, they came over after school.
Who are also brothers.
Yeah, they're also brothers. And we just, after school, they just came over and played guitar with us. And then my mom just recognized the music, like, growing within all of us. And she got us our first ever gig at this place called the Fort Clark Springs for Fort Clark Day.
It's a, like, retirement village.
Yeah.
Full of, like, 80-year-olds.
She was like, hey, y'all want to play live for these people? And we're like, yeah, sure. So she gave us her name, Bracket Young Guns. She got us our first gig. And...
We were in the fifth grade. Well, I was in the fifth grade when we started playing at like bars and restaurants.
That's when we were band.
That's when we fully got a band together, drums and all.
Mm-hmm. We've done our own individual instruments though. For like, I was 8 when I got my first guitar. Had flames on it.
Super duper awesome guitar.
All right. Well, I mean, we had always been like focused on trying to do music full time, like as a career, but we never really got serious to like, you know, drop everything else that we're doing and focus in on this. So like when that happened, it was like, it wasn't like we didn't know that we were interested in it. Like that was already
apparent.
It made
sense.
Yeah. That was boom. Blevins was born in San Marcos for sure.
Yeah, it was.
Like the collective, the name rallying under that, Blevins. We released Too Late to Come Down when I was a freshman in 2017.
Yeah, most of the songs were made in your dorm.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Your freshman year.
Yeah, they were, dude.
With the blue strat.
It can get pretty stressful being just a band of three brothers and doing it full time for your living. We write all of our own songs, we produce them, and I try to record at least 6 hours a day, but sometimes I do more. I think this last week, I had like 7 hours every day, so like 35 hours. But dude, for this last song, As I'm Fading Into You, the one we're working on right now, that one's probably been like 2 months, 2.5 months in the making. But it differs.
I think that's the quickest song that's ever been made. I mean, this whole process is obviously going to take a long time, you know, but I kind of get impatient sometimes. You kind of have to wait. There's no way around that. You know, just waiting for the album, because time makes greatness, you know?
Well, some songs we've taken a very freaking long time on because our laptop got stolen along with every other track, so we had to redo a lot.
Like about 50% of our album. But it was a blessing in disguise. Since we're doing it all in-house and not outsourcing anything, it's been very hard to have an isolated sort of petri dish out your environment to function as like a productive studio kind of thing.
Nephews, for sure.
Yeah,
Nephews was crazy. That was our first time we really pushed the gig out to as many people as possible. We really didn't expect that many people to come out, and it was just, the crowd was just awesome. And that was like all on us too. Like, we just promoted it. We went up to the venue, leveraged it out with the dude. That was crazy. Right after that, we were just. Well, I think we were more mind blown by the fact that we just did it all by ourselves, pretty much.
Mainly just reach out to as many people as we know and just tell them to go out, you know, on social media, Snapchat, just hit people up.
For bigger shows, there's video that we do, like video promotion.
Trying to make some super cool posters too.
But there is an aspect of communicating like weeks prior to the like venue, seeing sound situation, what we need to do, like playing the whole kind of leverage game when we're trying to get pricing and stuff like that. So you get dicey sometimes. After my freshman year, me and my buddies went to Zilker Park. We were just hiking, and I jumped in the river, and I just saw the waves of influence that I had on the water, but also on my friends. And I just thought to myself, like, damn, like, human potential is pretty limitless in terms of how much you can affect and how large of a scale you can impact just your environment and your community, but not even that, like bigger than a community, like a culture, you know. New Now is a concept album that was, it kind of came into its own fruition. New Now is a state of mind that can be measured by the time. The new is now possible, the tiniest sliver of range of time. And it's going to be a lot about self-growth and just evolving as time goes to different stages of seasons.
I'd say self-growth is like one of the main core things that we're trying to like push out there. I mean, without self-growth, you really have nothing in the long run.
The whole thing with the band is chemistry, and the depth of the chemistry will produce good results in the studio.
In one group, Dillon brings something, Brandon brings something, I bring something, and we just mold everything together all at once.
Either that or like we're just jamming together. Yeah. In like our old house in Brackettville, we've got like this big band room. We just set up and like literally play all day.
You can't get that kind of stuff with just a random person that you find to come play guitar with you.
You just keep thinking about the end goal. I mean, we talk about it all the time. We just want to do this our whole lives, so that thought itself kind of makes it easy.
Keeping in mind the bigger picture, it definitely helps. So just keep pushing, you know.
Everyone has their own subjective thing to offer to the world. This is just our thing. So.
We have like now 24. I think we might have hit 25 actually.
Yeah, maybe. I didn't check today.
Yeah, 25,000 of the listeners. It's awesome. Thank you. Majority of our fans are females. 75% females, 25% males. Yeah.
Pretty nice.
That's cool. I mean, you know, I'm for the bros too, you know? Bros out there. Bro's I can be a cool bro. We can do bro stuff.
Bro out.
Nothing's too hard when you got two bros.
God, don't put that in, please.